Hey Peggy, I was just gonna hop on here and show you your design boards that I've been working on for you. So we'll start here with the family room. So right in that front entry when you walk in, I just updated that light that you currently have. Just something pretty simple, but again, just an updated version of what you have. Doesn't hang too low from the ceiling, but just not flush mounted either is what I'm trying to get at here. But it's just oil rub bronze glass, and we'll let a clear glass that'll let off quite a bit of light. And then our main focal point here is this water's edge tree art, and I'm planning to put that on your blue wall that you have where the polka dot chairs are. Again, this is a little bit more softer, but really pulls out the colors that are in the chairs that you have. But like I said, more softer, so it'll contrast with the chair pattern that is pretty busy. And then up in the right here, you'll see the wall color is just this worldly gray. It's just like the perfect combination of brown gray. And this color will be pulled throughout majority of your house. Pretty soft, but will really still add color compared to just the white that you have now, but also pair nicely with the blue accent wall that we're working with too. And then in the middle here, these three things are kind of optional. I mean, everything is optional that I'm suggesting for you, but the biggest thing being this rug. Now that you're going to be going to a hard surface floor throughout, rugs can, kind of cozy up a space and just make things warmer. And so I know that we went back and forth because I also don't want to create a tripping hazard for you. So this will be completely optional to you. But just this stone and turquoise rug, pretty neutral. Little pop of blue to go with your walls, but again, just on the softer side. And then I have this navy waffle throw, and I wanted to use that throw that you have on your love seat currently, the kind of pink and red crocheted one. I want to move that to the living room, and I'll kind of explain that here eventually. And then some sage throw pillows. They're kind of a really pretty soft green, just to kind of pull out those greens that you have in this artwork and in your chairs, just to kind of throw on your dark brown sofas and brighten it up a little bit. And I should mention too, I only have one piece of artwork in here. You have quite a few pieces that I think we could work with and will work well. So, after we kind of purchase these items and get them hung up and then add in your pieces, if we still feel like we need more, then we can cross that bridge when it comes. But I'd rather utilize what you have versus suggest all these items that maybe won't be necessary. So that is, oh, and before I move on, this Urban Oak LVT flooring, it is a wood look, but it is a vinyl product. Again, kind of like your wall color, that perfect combination of the brown and the gray, but it'll pair really nicely with your oak cabinets that you have going on in the kitchen. So that is the family room board. And here is the kitchen. This is probably where you'll see a lot of the most change. Again, the walls, that worldly gray. Right above your dining table, I have this oil rub bronze chandelier. Two things I want to note here, not a lot different than kind of this type of light that you have now. I wanted to make sure that it was down light, meaning that the light bulbs will face down on your table surface versus some fixtures, the light bulbs face up towards the ceiling. These will face down and really spread out that light more because I know you don't have recess lights, and that was kind of one of your biggest concerns. So this will face down. It's a seated glass, but they're clear. So that will let off a lot of light too in that factor. To the right of that, I have these recess lights. If you wanted to update the recess lights above your sink, there's just a couple of them there. These are really nice. This is what electricians are using now versus that traditional recess light that you currently have. These are really nice because that little gray box there allows you to change the color temperature. So if you put them up there and you're like, well, these are too warm, I want them a little bit cooler, then it's just simply pulling out that light, tweaking the button over, and then you can have them a little bit warmer or a little bit cooler. So just new technology that they come out with that electricians seem to be using. On the left here again, I have this bronze wall clock. This is a really, really good size clock, and that'll go on that wall right above the sink, kind of where the roof peak is. So something quite a bit large, go up there and fill that space, but something round versus square. And then again, I know we talked about updating the microwave. The microwave is not linked. I typically do not reference appliances for clients just because it's a little bit out of my expertise level, but I didn't want to forget that that's something that we talked about. So there is a microwave here, but if you have a go-to appliance person where you've purchased other appliances, then that would be my recommendation for you when purchasing a microwave. And then is this ceramic backsplash. It's a 3x12, really pretty. It's a light gray, kind of has a little brown undertone in it. It's glossy, so it'll kind of reflect light, especially with your under cabinet light that you have. And this Hermitage quartz countertops, they'll also be glossy, so they'll help reflect light. But when you click on the actual picture to take you to the website, when you zoom in, you'll see that they have light gray in them. So the backsplash will complement those quartz countertops really nicely. And then just a stainless steel undermount sink. The same with the faucet. I did stainless steel just again to mix the browns and the grays. If you would prefer oil rub bronze, this faucet comes in oil rub bronze too. But I love mixing metals and spaces. So I think it'll pair really nicely with the oil rub bronze knobs and pulls that I have on the board here for you. Kind of a traditional feel with that square look, and will just pair really pretty with your antique furniture that you have going on throughout the rest of the house. Again, this urban oak LVT flooring throughout the space. And lastly is this Persian blue runner. Very traditional feel, but I love how it'll add a pop of color in your space and just kind of bring in the blues that we have going on with everything else. So that is the kitchen. Here is the living room, and again, kind of how I mentioned before, you have a lot of artwork that I think will work really well, so I've just been putting in some bigger pieces to fill up walls, but then we can kind of fill in with your smaller pieces, and if we feel like we need to purchase more, then once we get to that point, we will. But anyway, above the love seat, I have this wooden wall medallion. Very traditional feel again, but will pair really nicely with everything else that we have going on. The walls, that worldly gray, that table lamp that you currently have next to your navy chair, I'd like to actually move that to your bedroom. So here's one that I have suggested for you to update that. And then I talked about earlier too how I'd like to take that crocheted blanket, kind of that red and pink one, out of the family room and move that into here, because I think it'd be fun to kind of bring in the reds and a little bit of pink into this space, cozy it up a little bit more, because that stained glass lamp, I'm gonna move over here and switch or flip the lamps around from the living room and family room. So the stainless, or stainless, goodness, the stained glass lamp kind of has those reds in it, and then bringing in that throw blanket will bring the reds in too. And then this rug here that I have in the center, again, the rugs are optional for you, but the rug here that I have in the center is the perfect combo of the reds and the blues, and just kind of ties nicely with the rest of the house. And then lastly, just that Urban Oak LVT flooring again throughout. And for your next slide is just the garage and entry / laundry. Pretty simple. Again, the same light fixture that I used for your front entry, I'm thinking for your garage entry. The walls, that worldly gray. Flooring will move throughout that hallway too, back to your garage entry. And then I noticed too, you do have a rug currently by your garage entry. So if you would like to update that, this one is just pretty simple, pretty neutral, but just, yeah, more warm feeling to it. The laundry room will, the walls can be updated if you want them to be in there with this worldly gray. The flooring, same thing. The only other suggestion that we talked about in your laundry room is adding a second shelf above your washer and dryer. You have that white one, so easily could add a second one underneath and then really maximize that storage space in your laundry room for you. So there is the garage and the laundry room. Guest bedroom, again, very simple. Just updated the ceiling light in there. Kind of has the same vibe that I did with the other ceiling lights that we updated. I did the worldly gray in here again too. I think if we want to add a pop of color, we could with a bedspread, or the bedspread you have has color, but if you wanted to update the bedspread, the artwork that you have in there has a lot of color. That little floral piece above the bed, and then it'd be fun to work off that kind of mustard velvet chair that you have in there. So we could add in color simply through the bedding, the chair, and the artwork, and keep the wall still neutral. And then the carpet is just this Windsor Castle. Simple, but again, the perfect combination of that brown and gray that we have going on throughout the whole space. So that's the guest bedroom. The guest bathroom, here you'll see a lot of change again, kind of like the kitchen. Again, the walls neutral, that worldly gray. Anyhow, the vanity light, I really like this light. It's down light again, so it'll, you know, face down on the sink, face down on your face when looking in the mirror. Versus some vanity lights, they put the light bulbs face towards the ceiling. And then the mirror, just change it up a little bit, just something a little bit more decorative. But again, that combo of the silver and the oil rub bronze. And then moving on to your countertops, just kind of a clean white marble look. But that veining has the perfect combination of the browns and the grays again. So it'll really look nicely with your oak cabinets. And then the faucets and the pulls and the knobs. I did the stainless steel faucet, or the nickel faucet, like I did for the kitchen. But for the knobs, it's the exact same knobs and pulls, but they're in the silver finish versus the oil rub bronze like the kitchen. Just kind of makes it feel a little bit more airy, a little bit more cleaner. But you could go the oil rub bronze route if you wanted to match too, just because your light fixture does have that oil rub bronze happening. The shower curtain, this is really pretty, just soft. Kind of has a petal pattern happening into it, and I think it'll pair very nicely with your flower pictures that you have going on in the walls, and the yellow and just kind of keep things bright and airy. Again, with the yellow rugs, just updating them, just a neutral color, but adding in that yellow from the flower pictures. Two different sizes, one for by the shower, one for by the vanity. And then, oh, and I should note, too, the shower hooks, just updated those. I think the ones you have kind of a decorative look to them or something, but these are just neutral and will just kind of be clean, a clean look with everything else. And then this Colorado stone vinyl floor, as I've stated many times now, the perfect combo of the browns and the grays, but this will be a nice stone look for your bathrooms versus that wood look. So that's the guest bedroom. The master bedroom, this is one of my favorite spaces. I also love green, so there's that. But these Oyster Bay walls, pretty color, not too dark, not too light, but we'll definitely add some color in there. And then this wooden plank mirror, I'm thinking for right above the bed when you walk in. The mirror part of it is nice because they bounce around light, so it'll help brighten up the space too. But we'll really pull out that pretty green color in your walls. Mm-hmm. And then your bedding, I did this Chanel medallion bedspread. Nice, light, and airy. Has that spa kind of feeling that you were after. But with the medallion and that texture, definitely feels traditional and will work really well with your furniture that you have going on. And then I just contrasted that with just a light gray sheet just for a little bit of color. And then again, the carpet combo of the brown and grays. So there's the master bedroom. And then for your master bathroom, it's very similar to the guest bedroom, but just kind of has a little bit of pop of color and a little bit more of a spa feel to it. So that vanity light is the same, but this one is a 4-light versus a 3-light. I did not suggest a mirror for in here. That mirror that you have is pretty massive. I would suggest, though, maybe framing out that mirror, maybe in a white trim, just to make it look finished off and, like I said, frame it out. Again, the same countertops with that designer white undermount sink, has the perfect combination of the gray and brown and the veining to tie with your cabinets. And then the nickel faucets and the nickel pulls and, knobs just to keep things bright and airy. And then the walls is the sea salt. This is actually in the same family category as your wall color for your master bedroom, but very, very pretty. It has such a spa feel, adds color to your walls, but not overpowering. And then again, your shower curtain, more on the white neutral side, but I did add in that stripe of gray and then the little fringe on the bottom, just for a different texture. And then again, just updating those shower curtain rings. And then these sage bath rugs, I think, will pair really nicely with the wall color, add a little pop of color. This is a two-piece, so you'll have one for by the shower and then one for by the sink. And then the snake plant I added in here, this isn't linked. I can find you a fake snake plant, but if you would like a real one, that is something that we could purchase too. You could purchase real or fake. And I was thinking that on the right side of the vanity where it kind of angles off against the wall, just add a little height, add a little color. And then lastly, again, that Colorado stone vinyl floor, perfect combo of brown and grays, but stone look versus the wood look. And then my last slide for you here is going to be your window treatment slide. This slide doesn't really do it justice. We have the actual physical samples that we will bring to you in person when we meet next. But this just gives you an idea of what your options are. So the one on the left here is called Allure. And that's a transitional shade. It's kind of a hybrid of a blind and a shade. Again, I love this because when your shade is down, when the stripes line up, you can still have light come through, but if the stripes are offset from each other, then it completely closes it out and, light's not coming through. Versus the Genesis here, very beautiful window treatment too, but just a regular roller fabric shade where you either have to have it up if you want light or have it down if you don't want light. So totally what your preference is. So many different fabrics to choose from. So we'll bring these samples to you in person and you can see what they look like. So, but yeah, that is everything that I have for you here. And I'm excited to hear your feedback and yeah, just looking forward to what you think. So, thank you.